AR 2019, part not 218. See, in civil cases, most controversial suit was claiming title by adverse possessor. This is a complicated issue. Sometimes even courts take a risk of ruling different way despite the fact that title by prescription. That means if any person without any interference possesses any property for more than a period of 20 years, the property will have to remain for him. And in that years, the property will have to government will be property of that man. Understand this way of adverse possession. Number one, that a person who claims that the property was trespassed by the third party, then his right to recover the possessor arose from the date of class of action when the possessor was dispossessed. That should be filed within 12 years. That is another slab. On completion of that 12 years, his right extinguishes. Thereafter, only 20 years to be counted. This is the simple understanding of the title by prescription. Here, Shanti Devi versus Rajkumar Gupta, the suit was filed by the plaintiff alleging that his property was trespassed by the defendant. One contra defendant says the property was settled on him by exchange deed and family arrangement, but unfortunately that deed was not registered or executed and there was no document to prove that. Therefore, the court discussed Evidence Act 101, 104, Specific Relief Act Section 34, the Limitation Act 1963, Article 65, then Article 142 of the Old Act, Limitation Act 1998. These provisions were discussed and finally the High Court of Patna confirmed the degree granted by the lower court in favor of the plaintiff, rejecting the claim of the defendant that they were in possession, but they took two different steps. Number one, they say first title. Title means on the basis of exchange deed. Subsequently, they say they are in adverse possession for continuous use. You better go through the entirety of judgment. The lower court framed five issues, and you can understand how the issues were framed, but High Court has framed three issues, and by reporting earlier judgment of Supreme Court finally hold that the suit was able to be decreed upon court, the order was set aside. Major thing that paragraph 19 to be understood by careful reading, that for adverse possession one should prove that on what date he came into possession, what was the nature of his possession, whether the fact of a possession was known to the other party, how long his possession has continued and his possession was open and disturbed. These five elements is necessary to prove the adverse possession. So kindly go through the entirety of judgment, and you are not having complete knowledge about this area of adverse possession because there are multiple cases decided in different ways. Better go through institutions.